We are back here now to continue to talk almost about the Dallas Cowboys and their star wide receiver CeeDee Lamb after we just finished talking about Ja'Marr Chase and how actually an extension for CeeDee Lamb could benefit Ja'Marr Chase in the near future. But to stick on the Cowboys now and actually transition over to them, there's 24 days exactly until Dallas takes on the Cleveland Browns in their first matchup in week one. And that's going to be on September the 8th. Obviously, nothing is seemingly moving for CeeDee Lamb right now in terms of a contract extension. From an outside point of view, there could be a lot of things actually going on between CeeDee and, you know, the Dallas Cowboys organization. Who knows behind closed doors? But from everything that we've heard, from all the reports, from all the, you know, just predictions and things like that, from people that are really close to the situation, it's almost the same thing every time. I keep reading it every single day. New reports, new stories that come out, but basically saying the same message. You know, the Cowboys feel very optimistic. They feel like they're having good conversations. It might not be close, but they're feeling good about it, which is kind of hard to understand if nothing's, you know, really close yet, but you're still feeling optimistic. It's just, you know, really just doesn't make sense or how you could feel that way in regards to getting an extension done for CeeDee Lamb. I saw also today Dak Prescott mentioning that they're having good conversations in regards to his contract extension, but that also might be probably the fourth or third time I've heard that from Dak Prescott, and still, again, nothing getting done actually actions-wise in terms of extending your two most important players, arguably, outside of Micah Parsons. And there's now almost exactly 3 weeks left, and my question now with Micah Parsons saying what he is going to say, what I will bring up in just a moment here, to bring up the fact that, or expect CeeDee Lamb and Dak Prescott to both be there, it's almost a long shot for me, and I'll get more into it after I explain what Micah Parsons says. Micah Parsons, still, much like the Cowboys overall, he also is pretty optimistic and confident, actually, on CeeDee Lamb being there come week one, because he said, obviously, we miss him. He's one of the best people you can have in a locker room. I'm pretty sure he'll be here. And he also said that he's talking to CeeDee Lamb, you know, pretty regularly. He's watching the practice film. So he is still being or staying engaged with what the Cowboys are doing this year, but he is still holding out. He is one of the receivers that isn't present, hasn't been present all offseason. And unlike Dak Prescott, looking also for a contract extension, Dak has shown up and he seems almost very indifferent to the idea of maybe this being the last year for the Dallas Cowboys and Dak Prescott as a unit. He seems like he's pretty open and accepting of the fact that, you know, whatever happens, happens. If a contract extension comes, it's whatever, it'll be great. But if it doesn't, he seems perfectly fine with, you know, moving on. He's mentioned it in some comments before, and if that doesn't worry some Cowboys fans potentially over losing their quarterback, there's something wrong. Honestly, I would be pretty worried if I heard Dak talking about that. But also, just continuing on with what Micah Parsons had to say about CeeDee Lamb, he said he knows he's not going anywhere. The business side, they're going to take care of it, no doubt about it. On week one, he will be suiting up for the Dallas Cowboys. Sounding pretty convincing. It sounds pretty convincing hearing it, what Micah Parsons had to say in that answer. But Dallas players usually end up spilling information, honestly, before anything is done, or actually spilling out more information than they should have. So maybe Micah Parsons knows something, maybe because of this constant theme that we always see from Dallas Cowboys players of always spilling personal information or oversaying something that they shouldn't. Maybe Micah could be inclining everybody to think that this contract is actually close to being done, because he does sound, again, pretty convinced and pretty confident that CeeDee Lamb will be there. I truly don't believe he'll be there without having that contract first. So it's not a matter of fact of him just showing up because it is the first week of the regular season. I think he'll have no problem sitting out of that game, much like Chris Jones did last year when he sat out of the Lions game with the Kansas City Chiefs. They ended up losing that game, probably working out in Chris Jones's favor a little bit more. They lose that game, and then almost right after that, they extend Chris Jones to a massive deal, and it all works out. So I expect CeeDee to pretty much follow that same exact blueprint if he has no contract. I don't think he'll just show up because it is the start of the regular season. And now I wanted to get into this report by the Cowboys reporter, Cowboys beat reporter, John Machota. And he said from The Athletic, he said a bunch of his thoughts on how he feels this could play out, talking about a regular season deadline, almost like Micah Parsons was mentioning in his statement. John Machota said, "The Cowboys generally don't do deals during the season, so if Prescott doesn't have a new deal by September the 8th, it's probably not going to happen this year." And he believes also that Dallas could let him play out this last season, then circle back next offseason to see if they could work something out with him. So just taking that and acknowledging the fact that he basically said they have until the start of the regular season to get something done. Now, it isn't 100% certain that they wouldn't, you know, break that tradition, break that theme of not working something out in the regular season for, obviously, their franchise quarterback and one of the best receivers they've ever had, arguably. I couldn't see why they wouldn't break that that tradition, but based on how the Cowboys have done business over the last few years, according to Machota there, he said that it usually gets the regular season, the start of it, and then that's pretty much it. So the Cowboys have pretty much until that September 8th deadline to work something out. And also, continuing on with these reports, The Athletic's Jeff Howe chimed in, and he said that before this past weekend, that it doesn't appear that Dallas are relatively close to a deal with Dak Prescott, even though they badly want to lock him down. So, kind of contradicting there. You know, they're not close to it, but they want to keep him. Kind of inclines you to think that maybe the asking price for Dak Prescott, what he's asking for in a new contract, could be a little bit out of their pay grade, which seems a little ridiculous just because, again, this entire situation with the contracts has basically just been because of the decisions that the Cowboys have decided to take, because they waited so long, almost to the absolute last minute, to extend almost all of these guys at the same time. It's, you know, getting a little bit dicey now in extending everybody, even though, like Jeff Howe says, they badly want to lock down Dak Prescott, obviously because he just came off of a great regular season. He's their franchise quarterback. And again, he's just the quarterback in general. Teams want to keep guys around, obviously, playing the quarterback position, especially if they're playing to the level of Dak Prescott. But it makes you think that if they want to do it so badly, but they're not close at all, maybe the asking price is just not what they want to do. And now, that might seem like a Dak Prescott problem. That might seem like Dak's being a bit of a bad guy, maybe asking for too much. But you could also look at it in a way that maybe the Cowboys are just not willing to offer a value that a lot of people probably think is fair for Dak Prescott. You know, we don't know what he's asking for or anything like that, but maybe you could shape this in a way in thinking that the Cowboys might be being a little bit cheap, not wanting to overpay for Dak Prescott and wanting to do it. Of course, they want to keep him, but not willing to overspend in their estimation to try and keep him is what I'm trying to get at. So, you know, you could look at it a lot of ways, and I think those two ways are very similar if you look at that report and think, oh, wow, Dak's asking for too much. Who does he think he is? He shouldn't be worth that much. But also, maybe he's asking for, I don't know, $55 million or maybe just a little bit more, and the Cowboys are reluctant to pay that because it might be too much for them in their estimation. So there's always two sides of it. And also going back to John Machota's report, he seems pretty confident in that an extension for CeeDee Lamb is a little bit closer, so they can both, you know, both be done, but will they be able to have the opportunity to do both? And that's really where my thinking goes to with all of this. You know, with about 3 weeks left, and according to the fact that Dallas doesn't really do business after they're into the regular season, it's kind of hard for me to believe that they're going to give the contracts to both of these guys, market-setting contracts, in this time frame. You know, it's hard to do that, obviously, because it's taken so long already, and to, you know, invest so much money into CeeDee Lamb, he deserves it, over the next 3 weeks, but also hand out a contract like that to Dak Prescott as well. It seems like it's going to be a lot. It's going to be a lot in just this time frame, and they could be talking about it. They've been negotiating it for the longest time, but now, because of all the reports saying that they're not really close, I don't feel like they're going to find any sort of breakthrough in the next 3 weeks that they couldn't have already in the months leading up to this, you know, final decision now that we're really getting close to this deadline, especially if they don't do extensions, like I said, during the season. Mostly to avoid, you know, this holdout, you would want to get CeeDee Lamb done first, obviously, to have him be there. And it makes you think, where does that, you know, leave Dak? If you extend the CeeDee Lamb first, say, just because he's not there, you want to have him there and actually show up. Maybe you get his deal done first, but then what does that mean for Dak Prescott? If you invest a lot of money in CeeDee, are you still gonna give that amount of money to Dak? If he's not holding out or anything, so he's not really forcing your hand too much, but he does seem to be the more accepting, going back to the point I made before, of the fact that, you know, if he moves on, if the Cowboys aren't willing to meet his demands, he has no problem with, you know, having this be the last season for him being the quarterback of the Dallas Cowboys. And for two market-setting deals, again, it seems like 3 weeks just doesn't seem to be enough time to get that done. And that's my biggest issue now with, it seems like, the same reports coming out each and every day. I just feel like they're going to have to end up choosing which one to do before the start of the regular season, and that might just end up being CeeDee Lamb, because he's actually not there. He's not taking part in anything. He is holding out, and you want to make sure that he is there for that week one matchup, because they're definitely going to need it, playing the Cleveland Browns, matching up against Denzel Ward, having Myles Garrett come off the edge, and all the other talented players that they have. To not have CeeDee Lamb out there, they're probably going to be like 13-point underdogs or something like that in their first matchup, in all honesty. So they absolutely need him out there as much as they need Dak as well. Is 3 weeks going to be enough time for both of them? I feel like they're just going to have to decide. But let me know your guys' thoughts on whether or not you think 3 weeks is enough to get both of these deals done. And are we going to see both CeeDee Lamb and Dak Prescott out there come week one against the Cleveland Browns? You guys let me know what you're thinking and all your honest thoughts about this situation. But we're going to move on to another break. We have two more topics to talk about on today's show. Some takeaways from the joint practice this week between the Philadelphia Eagles and the New England Patriots. Not a lot of positive news coming from the Patriots side of things, but we're going to get into more of that. And then lastly, continuing on our series, the biggest remaining questions for the AFC South teams this time around, talking about the Jaguars, the Titans, the Colts, and the Houston Texans in the last segment of today's show. That is coming up for you guys, but we'll be right back in just a few seconds.